If you subscribe to Netflix, you'll want to know about a new email scam involving that service. Paula Fleming from the Better Business Bureau joins us this noon hour with word of this latest scam that attempts to steal personal information from consumers. How does this work?
Okay, so this is another example of a phishing scam where these scam artists actually use a well-known name. Netflix is a very well-known name. What's happening is they are contacting their subscribers, encouraging them to log on to their account, and when they do so, they say that the account has been suspended and to call customer service.
Wow.
Once they call customer service, that leads them into a whole unfortunate unraveling of their scam artists' process of getting their information.
And you're right, there's so many people who subscribe to Netflix. It's a fertile field for people to be scammed.
Sure.
There are three key indicators which we have listed that will help you know that this is a scam.
Yep. First and foremost, if it's not the Netflix phone number, if the web page is a pop-up, and the computer access. So you want to make sure that you go to the actual Netflix website, get their customer service phone number and contact them directly. You also want to make sure that the URL is a legitimate URL. Don't click on any pop-ups. Go directly to the website.
Now, this is interesting. They actually want to gain access to your computer, these scammers?
Yes, that's what they urge you to give them access once you call the phone number, which is actually in India. They gain access to your computer and therefore allowing them to access all of the information you can. So your social media, your financial information, so on and so forth. So you have to be very cautious about this.
So obviously, as the list indicates, don't allow that remote access. Don't click on the email links and then those odd URLs that you were talking about.
Yes, if it's not, for example, Netflix.com or, you know, or whatever the website we're talking about may be, if it's suspicious in any way, that's a huge red flag. And again, you never want to allow someone access to your computer that you're not sure exactly who's on the end of the other end of the phone.
And it's interesting, you know, there used to be a lot of telephone scams. Now all these scams are online. So one way to guard against being scams is to go the old-fashioned route with a phone number, right?
Yes, that is a good way. But a lot of us, you know, live our daily lives on our smartphones and on our computers. So understandably so, it's not the easiest way by picking up the phone. Sometimes you're put on hold forever. But again, phishing is exactly what it means. They're phishing for your personal and financial information.
So the last bit of advice on the list is look up the business's phone number.
Yes.
And that might help you to determine whether this is a scam or not.
Yes, definitely. Calling directly, reaching out to the business directly is always the best line of action.
All right. And as always, Paula Fleming from the Better Business Bureau, we thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.